Hello, and welcome once more to the business programme here on Kirklees Local TV. We've all seen and heard the statements from so many service sector businesses proclaiming how unique they are, and then when you bother to look at the websites or promotional material, they all look the same and offer legal or accountancy services that, strangely enough, also look identical. But every now and then you come across an organisation that does look different and appears to have a unique approach or specialisation. Now, one such company is Huddersfield-based Cornerstone Recruitment, a relative newcomer to the sector, and so I've asked founder Dru Widdowson along today so we can find out more. Dru, good to see you again, and can you tell us about what you do, how you do it, and why it's so different from other recruitment companies?
As recruitment goes, we specialise in 48 different industries, but we really do specialise in finding local people, yeah. You know, for companies. The idea behind that is, you know, if somebody's got a very short distance to travel to work, they're fully engaged, you know, when they get into work in the morning, and they're passionate, you know, about the, you know, the local businesses. That's one of the primary reasons.
So it is very much about local jobs for local people.
It's certainly local jobs for local people, yeah.
So what was the deciding factor for you that inspired you to set up a recruitment agency? And what do you think are the experiences you've had that have supported its success?
One was finding the best candidates out there locally. You know, I've been recruiting myself for a recruitment agency in the past. I've had good experiences, I've had bad experiences. And seeing people leaving the local area as well in the morning, going to Leeds and Manchester in the jobs, I thought, well, there's got to be local jobs for, you know, these candidates that are going up further and further afield for the jobs. And with business that I've done in the locality, you know, listening to business owners and their frustrations as well about finding people that are local, skilled people. Some of their frustrations have been people leaving after a very short space of time because they've found a job nearer to home. You know, okay. So it leaves quite a sour taste in business owners' mouths that, you know, these people are leaving them when they've trained them and they've brought them on board.
And of course, it's not only the turnover of people; it's the job satisfaction, the work-life balance, yeah. Things like that. When people are spending so much time travelling,
absolutely, and that was one of my drivers for setting the company up. I'd worked in Leeds and I'd worked in Manchester, and I'd sort of travelled an hour there and 2 hours there to get to work. And I got approached by a company in Elland to go and work for them, and I stayed there for 6 years. And one of my biggest engagements with that company was I lived down the road. I could be at work in next to no time, and I found myself refreshed when I got into work and eager to work and passionate about the job. And because I was working in the locality as well, I really enjoyed the job because I found it was making a difference. So again, that was one of the driving factors.
Because if you think about it as well as from a local perspective, I mean, how do you find businesses? How do you find clients?
Knock on people's doors.
I think that's one of the things that's one of the unique factors that you do, isn't it? It's very much sort of...
We don't wait for companies to come to us. We go to them. We're doing quite a lot of business now locally with quite a few companies. And the way I see it is if I'm doing work for these guys and we're doing a good job and we're delivering a good service, why can't I be doing work for everybody around you? So we go and knock on a few doors and say we're dealing with X company down the road. You know, this is how we're doing it. This is a success we're having locally. You know, can we come and work for you as well? And you know, the answer's been quite a positive, yes, please, you know.
Yeah. And do you specialise in anything in terms of particular sectors or particular skills, size of companies or anything like that?
Not particularly, no, because in my previous role I was going in and out of all different types of businesses, and one thing that I really do, I'm passionate about and I love finding out is about the business.
Yeah.
So we go into the business, we get under the skin of what they actually want, we get the owners talking about their business, so we can identify the sorts of people that are going to thrive in that area. So that's really key to us, you know, to go in there, understand what they want. So when we find people, we can find a really good match.
Yeah. So you can understand the culture of the business,
correct.
The products, the services
absolutely.
That they offer,
yeah,
and
really
things like that.
Really, really important.
And really pull that through. Yeah. So you're making sure that you're matching the right candidate.
Yeah.
And how do you work with candidates as well?
We work quite closely with candidates from the moment we get the CV to speaking to them on the phone. We get them in, we have a chat to them. If we can't get them in and chat to them, we do what we call a video interview. Yeah. And we get them on the phone, on WhatsApp, FaceTime or Skype. We really do try as hard as to actually see the candidate to gauge their, you know, how suitable they are for the client before we actually send any information on to the client.
Yeah.
So we work with them quite closely. We make sure if they're nervous about interviews, if they've been out of the interview sector for quite a while, that we explain what to expect, and you know, so they can really be themselves at an interview, you know.
So it really is about offering a personal service both to the employer and the prospective employee, really getting to know them.
Correct. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. We do take pride in that, offering a personal service. Yeah.
Yeah.
We're very friendly.
So it's very much like a dating agency.
It is a dating agency for jobs.
For jobs. Particularly local jobs.
Yeah. Which again is where the passion comes in, because you know, I'm a firm believer if we can find good local people, they're engaged in the roles, they love working for the companies that, then the company they want to do more. They feel
they're more likely to stay there.
Correct.
Right? And contribute more. Irrespective of whether it's
appreciated and they'll work harder.
A forklift truck driver or a finance manager or something like
we
that.
We deal with everybody, from admin through to senior managers.
Yeah. Now, although you've been in business for a relatively short time, has there been anything in particular that has given you a lot of satisfaction and made you feel it's all been worthwhile?
We set out this idea of what we wanted to achieve, and that's find local jobs for local people, and that's exactly what we've done. So that gives me great pride, you know, especially when, for example, if we're working with a company in Elland and we find somebody in Elland for that job, that gives me immense satisfaction, and the candidate as well, because all of a sudden, you know, you've got a candidate there who's not having to travel 10, 15 miles anymore. You know, it's a 5-minute hop in the car. Some candidates ring me up or email me and say, I'm walking to work now, Dru. I haven't done that in my entire working career.
Excellent.
It's weird. That gives us great satisfaction. But seeing the idea that we came up with, great customer service, really, really looking at the candidates at a very, very finite level, doing a very deep search locally, and offering great customers, you know, getting all those things right, and seeing it actually working exactly as we expected, that in itself is really, really good.
Yeah. And you see that you've got a successful match. There's a real satisfaction from that.
Correct. Yeah.
If we look locally now, how buoyant is the local labour market, and are there any sort of specific sectors or skills that are in high demand and facing a real shortage?
We recruit into 48 different sectors. We're seeing jobs, opportunities coming from every different sector on a regular basis. So reference the market being buoyant, yeah. There's certainly a lot of good opportunities out there for people.
And it's across the board, there's vacancies for everything.
Pretty much, yeah. You know, it can be quite hard to find candidates sometimes, you know, because we are specialising so locally. But a little bit of time, a little bit of effort behind it, and we're finding real good people for us, you know, for us clients. You know, we've had clients come to us and say, where are you finding these people from? And we've said, we're not telling you.
Obviously.
We're just fully engaged in all the different ways to source candidates.
We're sort of 6 months away now from this so-called Brexit deadline, and it's getting nearer by the day. What effect do you think that's having on the recruitment front at the moment or in the future?
From what I've seen over the last 12 months where we've been working, I haven't really seen it affect anything. I've seen companies recruiting. Companies are positive about the future. What I'm not hearing is companies saying we're going to be stepping back when Brexit finally comes into effect.
Well, this is it, and there's a lot of media speculation as to the negative cliff edge effect, but I mean, it's been announced recently about Talgo, the Spanish train manufacturer, looking to sort of base all their future manufacturing in the UK. 1,000 jobs, 40,000 square foot of factory space and things like that. And you think, why is everybody so depressed about things when there's so many positive, optimistic opportunities there?
Well, what I see businesses just getting on with business and being positive about the future. Brexit's going to happen.
The politicians, you know, we need to get on with it. Talking it down, and businesses just getting on with it.
Yeah, we need to get on with it, as business people would do. You know, it's whatever's going to happen, it's happening now. So that's the way I see
it. So in terms of getting on with it then, what advice, recommendations can you give to both prospective candidates and employers looking to work with and through a recruitment agency such as yours?
Candidates, make sure your CV's up to date.
Yeah. And you'd help with people that...
Correct, yeah. We offer a CV service as well to the candidate. Make sure your CV's up to date.
Yeah.
If you've got a job or you've got offers on the table, that you're going to accept, take your CV offline. It's very easy to do, and that'll stop recruiters ringing you,
right,
and chasing you. You know, be honest with the recruiter, you know, about what you're wanting to achieve, the sort of role that you want. There's some very, very good recruiters out there who'll work with you at a very personal level. On a business side, business owners need to trust the recruiter. And try, if they can, work with a single recruiter, because the more recruiters you get involved, the noisier actually gets. You know, and we do recruit a lot of us from the same pools of information anyway.
Yeah.
So chances are you're just going to be duplicating the work that you've got, or the candidates that are coming through.
Okay.
It's quite simple, really.
Well, that's it then.
I think so.
Thanks ever so much for joining us today.
Thank you.
And sharing your thoughts and experiences with us. And I look forward to seeing you again here on the Business Programme on Kirklees Local TV. Goodbye.